Hello clever people and welcome to this Q&A video. Today's question is from N00Buddy. Okay, I think that's the name. So, hi, thank you for your great videos. Well, my pleasure. I have a question regarding vertical stabilizers. You might have mentioned it in a previous video, but I was wondering why some fighter planes have a single vertical stabilizer and others have two. What are the pros and the cons of each configuration? That's a very, very good question. So, one single vertical stabilizer, two vertical stabilizers, two counted stabilizers. So there are three different design solutions, and let's try to see some considerations on why they're used and the reasons behind this. First, let's try to understand why there is a vertical stabilizer. So the plane is flying straight. Then, because of turbulence or any other disturbance, the plane starts going sideways. But the very fact that there is a plane, a vertical plane, a vertical fin in that position, a lateral force is developed, and the lateral force brings back the plane. This means that the plane is stable along the yaw axis. And this happens even if the pilot does nothing. The pilot has the rudder to be used to accelerate the recovery, but the plane left to its own devices is actually stable in yaw. The first consideration to do is the plane behaviors in stall conditions. During the stall, the aerodynamic surfaces suffer from fluid separation. By the way, this is just a schematic, it's not like this actually. But they leave behind a trail of turbulent air. If this trail of turbulent air actually hits the vertical stabilizer, the effectiveness of the stabilizer in stabilizing in yaw is actually reduced, and the effect of the wake, of the turbulent wake left by the aerodynamic surfaces is called the aerodynamic shadow, which actually affects also the plane rudder. So not only the plane risks losing stability, but becomes less maneuverable. Now, if we watch from above a plane like the Gripen, which is relatively thin, we see that probably the aerodynamic shadow just passes beside the vertical stabilizer, and a single vertical stabilizer in that position is probably the best place to preserve some level of effectiveness during the stall, even if some other turbulent air passes above the fuselage and hits against and flows against, flows around the vertical stabilizers and reduces a little bit the stability and the maneuverability. So why you have a single one? Well, because it is enough. Now, let us consider the F-15. So the F-15 has two vertical fins. It has large wings, but also a quite large and squat fuselage. The fuselage in the F-15 and in many other planes, in many other fighters with a similar geometry, is actually lifting. So it produces lift together with the wings. And this is part of the reason why it has such a good aerodynamic behavior. So in case of stall, as you can see, the aerodynamic shadow of the wings passes probably around beside the two vertical fins, but in a plane like the F-15, unlike the Gripen, you may actually have a stall of the lifting body. And above the fuselage in stall condition, you have a very dirty flow condition, you have separated flow. You can understand from this picture that the fins in this case are in the best position to preserve their effectiveness. Vertical stabilizers can stabilize the plane and the rudder still remain effective. Now, this is a symmetric stall, but in the case the stall is asymmetric, like in this picture, you may see that at least one of the stabilizers remains in clear flow and remains effective, while the other is fully immersed into the aerodynamic shadow of the stall wing. And mind, symmetric stall is quite rare. The norm is actually an asymmetric stall, so this is a condition that happens very often. Another interesting situation is one in which we have an asymmetric thrust. So one of the engine is failing and the thrust is off, is no longer symmetric. So this creates actually a torque in yaw for the plane, as you can see here. And the flow again in this situation is dirty on one of the stabilizers. So in general, you have two vertical stabilizers with planes that have a lifting body or a large and squat fuselage, because in those cases, if they stall, have a very, very bad aerodynamic field above the plane, and having two fins actually helps in preserving part of the stability and part of the maneuverability. For the F-18, the situation is a bit different. The F-18 has two vertical stabilizers, but counted a little bit outwards. Well, they are actually positioned to profit from the vortices created by the leading edge extension roots, that small delta wing that is just beside the cockpit and in front of the main wing. Those vortices are very energetic and help preserving the effectiveness of the vertical stabilizer, because the vertical stabilizer are actually wing profiles. They behave like every wing profile and they can benefit from the vortices generated from the legs, like the rest of the plane does. So that is it, they create somewhat what is called non-linear lift that help the plane reaching very high angles of attack. Another interesting advantage of the double stabilizer is the fact that may help masking a little bit the infrared signature of the engines, particularly the plume of the engine if seen from certain angles. Maybe in the F-15 is clearer, but also they reduce the rudder cross-section, which is one of the reasons why stealth planes normally have canted vertical stabilizers. So much for the aerodynamic considerations, but there are other different considerations that are more structural. So for example, if we consider the kind of force that is exerted by the stabilizers when they actually lift, when they do their job, well, they create a roll torque around the plane, which is absolutely normal. But this means that, for example, in this point, the bending moment is very high, so the local stresses are very high. The structure in those areas must be robust and also heavy, probably. But now, rather than having two vertical stabilizers, the F-15 had just one, for example, like this. Well, in this case, probably the force itself would be similar, this would be the same, but like you can see, the arm of the force is higher, the bending moment is higher, and the stresses would be even higher, so the structure need to be even more robust than in the previous case, and it means much heavier than the previous case. So actually splitting into the vertical stabilizer can help in building lighter structures, and weight reduction is always welcome on fighter planes. Have also to say, if this vertical fin is too large, it also becomes quite impractical, particularly for carrier fighters, where the room for storage, the room for parking the planes is actually limited. So, in summary, there are aerodynamic considerations about having a good behavior in stall conditions. There are structural considerations limiting the bending moment on the rear of the fuselage. Plus, there are some other practical considerations in having a tail which is not too big and it's easier to handle. Also, good positioning of the two vertical stabilizer can contribute to the reduction of the infrared signature and to reduction of the radar cross section. So, I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you are interested in learning more about the consideration that designers do when they design a plane, there is an entire playlist on the screen dedicated to the design of the Gripen. In the meanwhile, thank you very, very much for watching. Stay safe always, and see you next time.